Hi, I'm Vladis Vujovic and I'm Scientix Ambassador for Serbia. I'm also engaged in creating a MOOC for STEAM is Everywhere. For this activity, we decided to use physics and chemistry to combine the two classes. And the thing is that it rather went well when we decided to create jam. Because that way we decided to show our kids that physics and chemistry are not just subjects for themselves, they are also a part of a much larger group called technology. And the technology of making jam really depends from all the matter, all the things you have to learn from physics, from chemistry, from biology, and this is what our activity was about. Basically, we gathered around class, we showed them how to make jam and help them to learn lessons in a creative way. What can be improved is the fact that we could use much more heating sources. We can divide students in much smaller groups. Some of the students are thinking of this activity as a too much fun activity, but once they realized how much science is behind jam making, it all went rather well. I would also suggest for the teachers to use different fruits, even different vegetables. And of course, there's a little thing in adding pectin. We can deliberately make some jams spoiled, but not adding too much pectin. And this can be also activity. We decided this way just to make a little easier for us. We created two different jams and that's all.
So we cleaned them, peeled them and cut them.
And we tried to make as smaller pieces as we could.
And we add sugar and weight.
So we started to cook carrots and after like 20 minutes they were ready.
So we measured sugar and added it, then we boiled it a little while, but on a lower fire.
After we added sugar, we added lemon juice.
Soon enough sugar started to melt.
And then after that we waited like about 15 minutes more.
And there was even more water with carrots than it was before.
After 20 more minutes of cooking, jam was ready.
So osmosis was done last year in biology class, but this is the first time we did the experiment so we could actually see what happened.
I mean, it was a big surprise that we're making a carrot jam. It's not really common here.
In this town, I mean, nobody heard about carrot jam or something like that.
Yeah, and it's very unusual for our culture and city or country.
With pineapple, it was much easier. All we had to do is cut it into smaller pieces and once it boils, add more sugar. Sugar is not healthy, but this time it helps jam last longer.
Okay, so the thing is, when the jar cools down, it creates a lower pressure on the inside and it's higher pressure on the outside, so that's why it's so hard to open the jar after it cools down.
Another reason I decided to use carrots is because they are high on pectin, so you actually do not need to add anything else to your jam. However, to point out the importance of pectin, I decided to use another flavor and I decided to use pineapple. Because pineapple is really low on pectin, you can find them anywhere in the can and you can probably use it. And besides, I thought that pineapple jam could be a great taste. All jars were sterilized before the class. The only reason I did it because I didn't have the right equipment in my classroom. However, in some better equipped schools, this can be done with probably no problem. Because all you need is actually a big oven and heat them. That's all.